SMA is a devastating disease. It's a genetically based condition which causes certain types of nerve cells that live in the brain and spinal cord to prematurely die. The most severe form in these little babies called type 1, and the majority of these babies succumb to this disease before their second birthday.
A condition that affects the entire family, and so even though it may be the child or the young adult or even the adult that is actually affected, it is everybody in that family in some way.
Because these babies are born normal. You can't tell at birth that they have this deadly disease.
Found out we were pregnant with a girl, had a very successful, quick delivery. She was perfectly healthy.
So William was born and he passed his Apgar and everything looked great. And so we took him home. We had him at home for 30 days. I laid him down to go to bed that night. And when I woke up the next morning, I realized he was laying there like trying to cry, but couldn't cry.
First thing I noticed probably around 4 or 5 weeks is when I would put her on the changing table to change her diaper and her arm would fall behind her back and she wouldn't try to pull it out. I brought it up to our pediatrician and one of the serious things she mentioned were the letters SMA.
Well, I didn't know what SMA was. I never heard of it, and so I Googled it. It was very confusing because not only was my child terminally ill, but I was told would never eat or breathe or move on his own.
We were told she had 1 to 2 years to live, and we weren't really given necessarily a lot of hope other than just to make her comfortable.
William is ventilator dependent and has a tracheostomy. He has 24-hour care. His different machines he used to clear his airway and help keep his lungs expanded.
Really, within 2 weeks of diagnosis, we were leaving the hospital with the baby, was able to tube feed on BiPAP. We were lining up nursing care. I mean, our entire life just changed in a second. And I remember reading about SMA, and CareSMA was the first website I came to.
They offered lots of publications, lots of information on a topic that isn't very well known. They've been able to connect us with other families. Those have become my best friends. The conference is very important for all of my kids. It's so important for them to get to see other families experiencing life the same way we do.
It was a game changer for us, and I just felt so like determined. Like when I left there, I was like, we can do this, because I've met all these families who do it every day, and I know that we can do this.
Donating to CareSMA is very important because not only do they offer patient services, expanding and offering clinical care, but they also have been the biggest player in all of the research.
There is no doubt in my mind that we would not be here without CureSMA. The field has grown enormously. Progress has been remarkable. Research, that is what CureSMA does. Without CureSMA, we would not be where we are.
I think CureSMA has done a fantastic job of just helping to coordinate and organize these families to make a bigger impact. And that's through, obviously, the support and really funding the research to help find these drugs and hopefully find the cure for SMA.
Every single day that passes is another missed opportunity. Every day there's another baby born with SMA and their parents don't know.
I would tell any person, I would say, just look at these children and you're gonna wanna help them. And CureSMA is the one organization out there that's focusing on all the needs of children and families with SMA.